guys, welcome to today's video. In today's video, I will finally be sharing the science curriculum that I have chosen for the upcoming homeschool year. So as some of you may have known, if you've seen some of my previous videos, I have been struggling choosing a science curriculum for this year, but I finally made that decision. So today I'm going to be talking about why I chose the curriculum we did, some of the benefits for our homeschool that I see, and maybe some reasons that it may work out in your homeschool. Some important things to remember when I was choosing this curriculum. I was thinking about things like, was I going to do science individually for my two daughters or a group subject, which is what we traditionally have done with science? How teacher intensive was it going to be on like myself? Was I going to have to teach a lot? Was I going to outsource it with like an online course using the computer, which I didn't really want to do an online course. So that is why some curriculums didn't make the cut, because I didn't want to use an online curriculum for science. And then I wanted it all planned out for me. I wanted to have to do very minimal legwork for science. I really wanted an open and go type curriculum. But I did want it pretty like activity and experiment heavy. So I feel like I was kind of looking for a diamond in the rough, because I wanted it open and go, but I wanted lots of activities. I wanted more of like a general approach to science, not just very specific on one topic, because we are going to be using it out the whole year. If it was planned out for me, that was going to be awesome. So the science curriculum that we have chosen to use for the upcoming homeschool year is Apologia's Earth Science. So I didn't want to keep you waiting that was wondering. I'm going to get a little bit into it and show you some of the resources I found. But something super exciting is one of my besties, Nickie, who is also a YouTuber. I'll link her channel down below. They have also decided to use Apologia Science this year. And so she's going to be making a video as well. So we are kind of collaborating together on these videos. I'm going to be talking about the Earth Science curriculum from Apologia, and she's going to be talking about their zoology unit. So I know I can't wait to see the zoology one. So go ahead and check out her channel and her video if you're interested in the zoology unit from Apologia. When I was looking through samples, they do seem a little bit different in how they're kind of set up. So I'm excited to see that video as well. So now getting into why did we choose Apologia? Well, I chose Apologia because it pretty much checked all of my wants off for a science curriculum. It is something my girls can do together. So with Apologia, they have their elementary series. This is called the Young Explorer series. And they have a bunch of different like science options, but their elementary series can range from like first grade all the way up to sixth grade. And that's because of the content. You can adapt it, as well as they have variations in their student notebooks for the different grade levels. Now in the future, I'll probably share a more in-depth like review, flip through to show you way more about the curriculum. I'm just trying to give a general overview of why we chose it. So what I was showing earlier, this is the textbook-ish, the reading book. This is everything you technically need as far as like your teacher guide, your student guide. This is where all the information comes from. They do sell these things called student notebooks. Or notebooking journals as add-ons if you want them. And I really like my kids to have something physical to write on, to take notes on afterwards, little activities. So this is where you can get the different ages. So this top one is junior. And so this is what my third grader will be using, because this is for first through third grade. And then the normal one, just the notebooking journal, is for fourth through sixth grade. So you can teach them together. But then they have kind of some differences within some of the notebooking. Obviously for the fourth through sixth grade, it just goes a little bit more in depth. So like I said, I'll do some flip throughs soon on these to go more in depth. But that was something that really caught my eye as, wow, I can still do the science together with them, but at their own levels. And speaking of that, I was actually looking at Apologia more long-term for middle school and high school sciences, and I really liked their middle school and high school programs. And so it made sense, well, if that's something we're looking at for the future, we should try it out now. And so because their elementary series goes up to sixth grade, that means this year and the following year, I can keep my daughters together, and then my oldest can branch out into her individual middle school science where they get a little bit more intensive. Now, the other cool thing about it is you don't have to do the specific topics of science in any order. So like we're doing earth science, that one seemed the most general to me out of the elementary series. They obviously have the zoology, but there's three different zoologies. So if you have an animal lover, you're set. And then they have botany, they have astronomy. I think they have like a chemistry and physics one. So you could use them for all the elementary years, going through all the different subjects. So we chose earth science. Like I said, I feel like that was a good overall. It covers some of the things that we've been working on this current year. It introduces some new topics. Overall, there's gonna be 14 lessons in this curriculum. And so we do plan on using this for our entire homeschool year. Something that is really cool, if you buy the student notebooks, which I think it's kind of odd, it's in the student notebooks. But whatever, I think it's because you would really only follow this schedule if you were also using the notebooks, but it gives you a suggestion of how to use this curriculum, 2 days a week, which actually works perfect for us. It is a little bit more time than we're used to dedicating to science, but 2 days per week, and we'll finish this and I think around like 32 weeks. So it wouldn't even take our entire school year. So we may take a break from it and work on something else in the meantime. But this, so see how it breaks down like week one, do this lesson and this lesson, and then it keeps moving on throughout the weeks. Oh, and I lied, there's 28. So definitely doable in a homeschool where you wouldn't have to do it every single week. You could definitely break it up. And now I don't know how well those, you know, suggested activities and lessons are, like how many minutes they'll take, because we haven't started using it yet. So that is something that as we start using it, I'll give you guys more updates on. So one of my other, you know, things I was thinking about was how teacher intensive is this going to be. I have to be very selective in curriculum with what I'm going to use my time on, because I am a working homeschooling mom. And let's just be honest, all of us moms are busy and it is very difficult to teach every subject. Well, with these Apologia textbooks, you know, your students, especially the older elementary, you know, I'm talking about a third and fifth grader who's gonna be using this. It is written in a way that they can read it themselves, honestly, and complete the activities. Or you can do it family style, you can read aloud. Apologia offers the audio of these books. So I actually did purchase the audio book of this, and so we can actually listen to it. And then I did opt to get two textbooks, which is not required at all. But knowing my kids, they do better with their individual books. And so what science will look like is they will each have their own textbook. We'll be listening to the audio version of it, and that's how they're gonna be completing their lesson. So semi-independent. I'll still be around to guide them, because then there's activities and things they're gonna need to complete. But as far as the text and stuff and their like notebooking journals and stuff, they're gonna do a lot of that independently. So my girls get to do it together for this year and the following years. And then I see this as a long-term curriculum into the middle and high school years. As well as it isn't super teacher intensive. I'm making it as unteacher intensive as I think is necessary with the using the audiobook, each of my kids having their own textbook to use. It's all planned out for me using that two day a week schedule that's provided. And then something that was really important to me is I wanted it to be fun and experiment or activity heavy. And so this curriculum has activities, either one or two activities every single lesson, which is just amazing to me. Plus they have like a course long activity. So because this is earth science, they're actually gonna be making an earth, But then throughout the lessons, they will add things like water and landforms and rocks and, you know, to make up a whole earth of all the different things that they're learning about. So there's that year-long project and then mini activities and experiments all year long in every single lesson. Now, before you all think I'm absolutely crazy, the reason that this activity heavy thing is going to work is because I also found a lab kit. So there's a company called Nature's Workshop Plus. They have their own website, which I'll link down below, and then you can find their lab kits on like Rainbow Resources. I think Christian Book has them. And basically what they do is they look at all these different science curriculums. So it's not Apologia specific. They do it for BJU. They do it for all these other science curriculums, and they go through their material list, they go through their activity list, experiment list, and they put together an entire lab kit of everything that you need. And let me tell you, it is amazing. So it comes in a big, huge box. If you would have seen the day, because I ordered two, which I don't know if I needed to order two for each of my daughters, but I did just so we had everything we need. I will update you more once we start using it if two wasn't needed, but we got these huge boxes. And so all that I did is I took everything out of the box and I put it in these little storage bins for easy access. Now what they do is they bundle everything that you need per lesson or per lessons, depending on like what's happening. So this is for lessons 3 and 4. So I know that I just need to grab this pack and everything that we need is in here, or there's notes like, oh, this is actually in, there's like a miscellaneous kit that has like coloring stuff, or it's loose in the box, like it's too big to go in a little baggie, like wire hangers. Because if I saw that wire hangers were needed in an activity like in other curriculums, I wouldn't even know where to get wire hangers. And I also wouldn't want to buy a pack of them when you only need a couple. So just things like that, just really the convenience of it and honestly money saving, because they give you exactly what you need to get things done. This is for lesson 2. So I mean, there's pebbles in here, there's sand, there's an Etch-a-Sketch. We have like 2 full-on paint tubes in here. This one, I mean, food coloring, glitter, borax, pipe cleaners, and all organized for you. If you've been around my channel, you know my love of knowledge crates, because they do something extremely similar for like craft type stuff. And that is a game changer. And so having this similar concept really, really helps. And so pretty much everything, I think, except for like water or like perishable food items, if you need those, is included in these kits. So that really does turn it into an open and go, because I know we have everything. I know it's all organized. The activities have step-by-step instructions, and they just look like tons of fun. So I know that my kids are absolutely going to love doing all this, and that was a huge reason for choosing this curriculum, was the hands-on activities, how heavy that is. Now, if you're like, I don't want a curriculum that has that heavy of activities, one, you just don't need to do them. The information you have, the notebook journaling, you don't have to do all the activities, or maybe this curriculum isn't for you. But for those of you that are really trying to be intentional about having those really fun things in science, I think that Apologia has laid it out well, and then having these lab kits to add on, just again, it's that convenience factor to make it a lot easier. All right, just some examples. So remember that project I was talking about? So this is in lesson 5. You're mapping out the continents on the Earth globe. And so they give you some real life picture examples how to do that. Also in lesson 5, there are some crystal growing activities. So your children will be growing crystals. Also in lesson 5, they are making edible rocks, learning about the different types of rocks and layers. And so I think there was actually a couple recipes. Yeah, so there's another recipe. So as we go through this, I don't know if I would think it's necessary making 3 dessert type treats of different rocks to show examples. See, here's another one, making edible rocks. So those are things that we may need to maybe not do or break them up a little bit more. But at least you have the options. Everything is super colorful. They have both realistic pictures and then, you know, drawings to kind of help kids understand. You know, there's like little vocabulary words that they highlight. There's just so many different topics and stuff that are just really great. So looking through the junior notebook and I guess normal older kid notebook, there's really, most of the pages are exactly the same. There are some small things I'm noticing, like the writing lines in the younger grade. It has, you know, a little bit help for the handwriting, and then the older grade, it's just blank lines. But really all the activities and stuff honestly seem the same. So once I get more into it, I'll make sure to kind of tell you what the differences are, but as of right now they're pretty similar, which I think is good when you are teaching multiple kids at once to keep them on the same page. But you could, like, I know I do make my older daughter, you know, go a little bit more in depth in her writing or explanations. So it kind of gives you the freedom as the parent to choose how you guys want to use those notebooks, if you even want to use them. Bought through Apologia the audio book, and so it breaks it down by each lesson is a separate audio file, or you can just download the entire audio book at once, depending how you use it. But I can just log in, here's lesson 4, I can click on it and then download, and then it will just
view. Have you ever thought about how the earth is really every person's home? It's also home for all plant and animal life too.
So very simple. I can have that on the iPad. I can have it on the computer playing for them. Whatever's going to be the easiest to work out. But again, that really helps me not have to read it out loud to them each lesson. So I would love to hear your guys' thoughts. What do you think about my choice for using Apologia for the upcoming homeschool year? Have you had any experience with Apologia yourself? I do have an affiliate link down below. So if you are interested in checking out Apologia, make sure that you use my link down below. I'm not sure of any current specials specifically on science, but I do know right now if you purchase their science and math together, so you get like a science curriculum and a math, you get 20% off. I actually am super excited because I will be working with Apologia specifically in the next month or so with their new math curriculums and this earth science curriculum. So I do have more content to share with you guys. I'm really excited to check out their math. I've never seen it before. So I'll definitely be sharing some reviews with you guys when I receive those items. Have a wonderful day, guys. Don't forget, go check out Nikki's channel down below. Check out her thoughts on the zoology unit and everything that she's going to share on that. Have a wonderful day, guys. Bye.